Hello, my name is Scar and welcome to my channel. Today we'll be reacting to the 2.1 trailer for Genshin Impact. Disclaimers first, my audio is shit because I'm recording this at night time again and societies are going insane, of course. Also, what was the other thing I was gonna say? Oh yeah, to some extent I kinda don't want to watch the trailer because they mostly reuse most of the scenes from the actual game and use it for the trailer. So it's just a massive spoiler. Well, trailers are already massive spoilers. Never mind. Let's get into it. Here we are.
Repeat after me.
Okay.
3, 2.
It's Miko.
1, 2, 3.
Whoa. We were just getting treated like a baby just now.
You know, the earliest shrine on Watatsumi Island was not located in Sangonomiya. But after she struck down our protector deity, the shrine was abandoned.
Recently, some of our soldiers started showing symptoms of accelerated aging.
If that's the case, then the peace talks are likely a trap.
People charge in here as they please. So uncivilized.
Senyora is the one behind all this?
Okay.
Have you learned your lesson now? The way you follow me around. Like a dark
shadow. Whoa. Oh, this rock music.
Ashes will remain.
Let's get them. Protect Madam Kujo.
I will do everything within my power to defend my family's honor.
Strike! Storm the front!
You Kujo scum! Colluding with the Fatui isn't low enough for you already! You just want to take everything away from us!
To survive hardship, you must prepare
for hardship.
Hey,
it's Kokomi, so... Yo, yep. Her attacks are fancy.
Some ambitions have the power to heal wounds, to bring victory.
Oh!
Indulge
that is Kazuha fighting ball.
What is the reason that I find you standing here before me once again?
Ooh, another fight! Round two with Maul.
Shine down!
Yeah, she's gonna be a failed character. I don't have enough primo gems for that.
Yoo-hoo.
Yo, that was her elemental burst. Yeah, hopefully this time we don't die in one
Surely
hit.
Surely you don't think your ambition alone is enough to shake A's will, do you?
Ooh.
That's it. Just like that. Eternity stretches things out over a long time.
Scaramouche.
But each moment within it becomes all the more fragile.
Whoa. Oh, okay, that's not yet the end. Okay, we're back at the
New Year. This is starting to feel like chili pepper weather.
Did you happen to see how the city looked on the way over here? Everyone's getting ready for the Moon Chase Festival.
Another festival.
This year's masterful chefs. If possible, I'd like you to be my culinary consultants.
There is one dish that perhaps you could try making for me.
We have two extraordinary talents this year. I'm interested to see their choice of dishes.
Okay, without further ado, let the cooking commence. Begin!
Okay, looks like I actually thought we were gonna go back to... what are the words? Actually, let's finish this trailer first before I give my thoughts. Okay, that's it. Based on the events, it looks like we're going back to Lue. I did not expect that, especially coming from MiHoYo, because after we finished with Mondstadt, we just forgot about it pretty much. We had one festival and everything was about Lue. I thought we were just gonna have all Inazuma events. Looks like we're going back to Lue. That's interesting. But first, let's go back. First of all, Miko is very friendly with us. I don't know if this is us she's talking to or is it Sayu, but she seems really friendly.
You know, the earliest...
So, whoa! This is like a whole nother city. So I'm assuming this is Sangonomiya. This is like the island we saw. From when we are at like the Shogun's Mansion, you can see an island off the horizon which you can't go to. So it seems like this is gonna be it. Wait, I just remembered there's supposed to be 6 islands. So yeah, this is gonna be one of the islands. I'm gonna assume this is Sangonomiya based on because Kokomi is talking it. This is totally themed on her.
Shrine on Watatsumi Island was not located in Sangonomiya. But after she struck down our protector deity, the shrine was abandoned.
Oh, but who is she talking about? Is she talking about Ball? Ball struck down their protector deity or someone else?
Symptoms of accelerated aging.
If that's the case, then the peace talks are like...
So, looks like it's not just fucking war, there's actual peace talks. So it looks like it's not gonna be as simple as Sangonomiya versus Shogun's army, boom. It's not just gonna be like that. Based on this, oops, I just hit the mic. Based on this, it's not just that simple.
Likely a trap.
Here we have an hydro hypostasis. I don't okay. Oh fuck, I just realized they're probably gonna add this spiral abyss. That will suck. Wait, whoop. No, that's an electro oceanid or electronid. That's probably what's gonna be called. God damn it, no! Well, that we have our first two bosses.
The way people charge in here as they please. So uncivilized.
Senyora is the one behind all this?
I did not expect this. A lot of people were like saying like Senyora's gonna be a part of what 2.1. I didn't believe them. I thought it was just like hopeful because she's hot. Oh, it looks like what they were saying was true. Damn! This music! Damn!
Not even ashes will remain.
Ooh, is she like a butterfly team? Butterfly or mod team? But let's go back to that. Looks like we're gonna have Signora as a part of the story. So, once again, of course, the Fatui is gonna interfere with our mission. And maybe the Fatui is gonna be our way that we get into close relations with the Shogun's army, with Ball. Maybe helping them with the Fatui will get them to like us more, so it'll be a bit more friendly towards us. At the same time, Senyora is probably gonna become a raid boss from this, the same way Child is right now.
This will remain.
Protect Madame Kujo.
I will do everything within my...
Alright, looks like we're gonna have more political problems based on this. We're gonna get to see more of that in the story. But yes, we're gonna get to unlock Kujo as a 4-star. 4-star? I can't believe she's only a 4-star. She totally deserves to be a 5-star with that design. Holy fuck, she's hot.
Strike! Storm the front!
You Kujo scum! Colluding with the Fatui isn't low enough for you already!
Wait. Did they collude with the Fatui or is it just a misunderstanding? I don't know, but... Here we have a preview of Kokomi's skills.
You just want to take everything away from us.
To survive hardship, you must prepare.
This seems like a new enemy.
Rest and rebuild! Covenant of the Deep!
Some ambitions have the power to heal the wounds, to bring victory.
So, I'm not sure if we're gonna see this happen now. It's Kazuha fighting Ball. Maybe this was a flashback, or this is gonna happen.
Indulge my curiosity.
And looks like something happens with the statue. I mean, look at all the visions lighting up. Probably something going against Ball, but... Yeah, that'll be interesting to see later on.
But I find you standing here before me once again.
Hey! We get Ball's playable character. Almost everyone knows that. Also, we get to experience her on... Round 2 on 1v1 against her.
Now you shall perish.
I do love how from the looks of it, her elemental burst is the Boba Sword. Hell yeah. I love the rock music, the rock music mixed with the Japanese music. I mean, mixed with the Inazuma theme. It's really enjoyable. And our round two. This is probably gonna be reused in game. At least we didn't get one hit.
Surely you don't think you're
But this is interesting. Miko is helping us. I don't know if she's like an observer or she's actually secretly against Ball, but I find this interesting.
Mission alone is enough to shake A's will, do you?
That's it. Just like that.
Over a long. Well, more problems with the Fatui. Scaramouche, yeah, is making his second appearance. He's back.
Long time. But each moment.
Well, this time we're gonna be fighting two Fatui Harbingers.
Within it becomes all the more fragile.
Alright. We just got fucked over. We fell asleep. I don't know what's gonna happen. I mean, from Signoi. I lost my words. I don't know what this part is all about. Because Signora is about collecting the gnosis. Scaramouche, what are you doing here? I mean, I bet it probably has something to do with the Tartagimi energy, like the thing that happens in the island with all the electro aura that kills you. I can tell that based on the bone marrow here. They're probably harvesting like the power of that dead dragon.
For a long time.
And I'm just talking out of my ass. I'm just trying to predict shit so I can seem like I'm smart after I... if I get something right.
But each moment within it becomes all the more fragile.
So what else do we have? Scaramouche is back. Looking scary as ever. And that's it. This is all just events, right? Oh, yep. I already addressed this earlier. We're going back to Clue A. Alright. This is great. Well, that's a good refresher. Especially after we just went through the Dead Zone. For those... The Dead Zone, I mean, it's like the time in Genshin where you have nothing to do, but you cleared all the events and there's new event. And that's the Dead Zone in Genshin. And when the Dead Zone happened, most people quit. That's why this is good that it came out now. That's something to be excited about. Well, it looks like we still have 2 weeks to wait, but I'm excited, especially with the Arcane Quest. I enjoy like the Genshin Impact story the most. Yeah, can't wait to see what happens here. Sangyeon, Mia, Ball, Cook, Sarah, and the Fatui. Ha. And with that, that's my thoughts on the new trailer. It's really interesting. I'm kind of excited. I am excited. But I'm most curious about, Yai. I really can't tell.
1, 2, 3.
I really can't tell if she's against Ball or something. Never mind, this really doesn't matter. Yeah, a lot of big things are gonna happen. The events, I don't care too much for them. I just need 3 more gems. And I just hope they give me enough to wish for a Ball. That's all for this video, thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. Probably if something interesting comes up in Genshin. Bye.